Hey there, I'm Darren Martell, serial entrepreneur, investor, and creator of SaaS Academy. In this episode, I'm gonna share with you the thinking process to decide if you should do the big rewrite or refactor your code base. I know it's the big question. I'm gonna give you some different thoughts, some examples, and specifically at the end, I'm gonna share with you how to get access to my code base remodeler framework. It's a worksheet that not only talks about the metrics you should be monitoring to know if it's a today thing, it's gonna talk about the prioritization strategy that I teach my coaching clients, as well as the five rules to make sure you don't end up back in the same place that you are now as you rewrite or refactor your whole code base. Let's get into it. So, fun fact, most people don't know this, but I started my career as a developer. I'm technical. I used to write code. I wrote code for over a decade. I taught myself how to code when I was 17. I started in Perl, did Cold Fusion for some of you OGs around, eventually .NET, Microsoft Stack, and kind of fell in love with Ruby and Rails and kind of, you know, web and all that fun stuff. But my first few companies, we did a lot of work refactoring, recoding, and really rebuilding new platforms for a lot of the world's largest companies, the Fortune 500. So I have the experience of like what they said it would take, you know, in regards to the engineering team on their team, our team, versus what happened, because I was managing these projects. I probably did, you know, 12 rewrites in my career over a 4-year period. So I have like 10,000 hours of experience, and I had to extract and build my own methodology for when it makes sense versus when it doesn't. When does a refactor process, which is not throwing away everything old, but slowly cleaning up and modernizing your code base, makes more sense? And if you're non-technical, this can be a big question. It's literally, you know, when you've got like, do I put off launching anything new to my client base for what your developers say, well, 6 months, which I've discovered is probably more like a year, or even worst case, 2 years, sometimes 3 years. Most people forget, you know, Netscape went through a 5-year period before they launched their next version because they kept trying to stick everything into it. And then, you know, I've gone on and I've built Flowtown and Clarity, and I've had to do big, big refactoring projects there, but I never went through the rewrite, okay? So, and the reason why is I believe that if your core data structure is gonna stay the same, okay? And there have been situations. We bought a company and when we looked under the hood, you know, we realized there was no referential integrity in the data structure. It wasn't a relational database. It was kind of like this flat file with keys that were hard-coded in the front-end code. And in those cases, we decided to rewrite it. But for the most part, you're gonna wanna refactor. Now, what you may not have experience is how to think through that process. And that's what I wanna dive into to save you hundreds of thousands of dollars and years, not even months, years of not having a competitive product in the market. So let's get into it. Number one principle is love your legacy code, the current code. If you have any kind of revenue and customers and you're debating if you should rewrite it, you should first off acknowledge that this code has got you to a place where you have revenue and you have a team, and this is a tough decision. Because if you didn't have those, this wouldn't be a tough decision. You would just decide to rewrite it. So not only should you love your legacy, you should understand that there's certain parts of it that are good. And I know, you know, maybe it's your part-time CTO or your contractor or even your co-founder. You know, technical people will always come in and say, we can't do this because we don't have a modern platform. We can't do this because of that. If you don't have glaring data concerns on the core data structure or security vulnerabilities that can't be fixed through upgrading different components in your code base, then it is very unlikely that you need to do a full rewrite. Instead, consider a refactor and understand that there's ways to pull out. I'm gonna get into it. Pull out the feature sets to allow yourself to refactor the code base in smaller chunks. But the first principle is just know that you should love your legacy code. Number two is think small. So most people think, I'm going to refactor this whole thing. And then what you do is you start working down that path and you start looking at like other features you could sneak into the roadmap. And you know, so it's not even like I've got to rewrite all the features that I currently have and make sure I have feature parity, but now you're like thinking of like innovation. So it's like, oh, what if we add this? How much more time would it take? And then your engineers will say like 2 weeks. And it's not 2 weeks, it's 6 weeks. And it's not even 6 weeks, it's the fact that you just delayed the whole project, so it's the exposure of not being in market. So what I wanna recommend is as you're rewriting your code base, think the smallest granular piece, okay? I'm gonna link up a bunch of links below, which is probably the five most powerful articles from people way smarter than me. If you're not technical, I'd still encourage you to read these articles because it will help you understand why you should focus on a rewrite, not a refactor, not a rewrite, and use that to argue back with your engineering and technical team because these are people that are way smarter than probably anybody working on your code base, the top minds from some of the best companies in the world that talk about this. And here's just proof. Have you ever heard of like Facebook version 4 and Facebook version 2? And I've seen like, man, one time I asked my coaching clients, I have hundreds of coaching clients in SaaS Academy. And I asked them, how many of you still have an older version that your clients use of your code base? And I'd say it's about 8 to 10% of people had like a classic version and then the new version. Trying to maintain two code bases and being competitive when you've got a bunch of kids at Y Combinator that've got millions of dollars in funding, you're just gonna get your butt kicked. So think small when you go to rewrite or refactor. Don't rewrite. Honestly, most people listen to this, you don't need to rewrite, you need to refactor. Number three is focus your fix. So I always recommend that you focus your fix based on the thing that breaks if you 10x your capacity today. So all of a sudden tomorrow, boom, great marketing strategy brought in 10 times more customers. Ask your engineering team what breaks, what part of the code base is gonna completely melt. Focus your fix on those areas. And the way you do that is you think about like remodeling a house. I don't tear down the whole house to change the kitchen, right? I work on the kitchen. And I wouldn't even start on the kitchen because the kitchen's a place where people need to eat and live. I might start with a bathroom remodel and then some bedroom remodels and maybe the basement and maybe the living room. And then maybe after I got really good at remodeling those areas, because it's a skill set that your engineering team may not have experience on, then we're gonna attack a bathroom or you know, the kitchen where the food is made, because that's gonna be a very big disruption. But I always ask myself, where will this thing fall down if we 10x in our work, in the load or the capacity of our system? And that's where we want to focus our fix. Number four is be quiet. That's the nice way I say it. Normally I'd say shut the F up. And the reason why is so many of you are building products and rewriting or coming out with new versions and you start talking about it. And you start talking about all the cool stuff. And you use your events as like launch pads to tell everybody how amazing your next version is gonna be. Or you know, partners are upset because it's totally buggy and you use that as the answer. And what happens is you now have made a commitment and there's no way to work backwards. I would highly recommend that you just keep iterating and creating a process to improve and not make it about a big event and just make it a cultural thing that you do of just coming out with new versions, right? And improving the code base. And think about like, to me, when I think of product management, there's three core areas. There's the business needs, there's the customer's needs, and then there's technical needs. And all three need to be considered in regards to the limited resources we have on our engineering teams to focus solving those three core areas. So it can't be just business needs all the time. And it can't just be, you know, paying down technical debt. It has to be all three considered. And be quiet when you're doing this so you don't set expectations that you can't pull back from with your client base, okay? So that's number four. Number five is respect your life cycle. So in the software world, there's a thing called software development life cycle. And it is everything from how you decide what you're gonna build it, how you test it, how you quality assure it, how you push it out to production, okay? So that's everything from like your Scrum. If you've never heard of Scrum, go check that out. Agile development is usually probably the most standard. Maybe you're doing some pair programming, that kind of stuff. But you know, it's your code base, it's your Git flow. Check that, those terms. Again, I'm gonna link up some of my favorite resources below. And your CI/CD, your continuous integration, continuous deployment process. You know, and I can usually tell people's maturity of their code base based on the frequency that they push to production and test coverage that they have on their code base. If you don't have those things figured out, then you probably don't have a good life cycle. And I would highly recommend that you not only implement it, but respect it, especially if you're the founder, and not push people out of fast, you know, hot fixes. If you have a conversation with your team every week about hot fixes, then you're clearly moving way too fast. You need to slow down to fix and respect your life cycle. So quick recap, 5 areas to look at when you're considering rewriting versus refactoring your code base, which I recommend refactoring, is 1, love your legacy. 2, think small. 3, focus your fix. 4, be quiet. Don't tell your customers. And 5, respect your life cycle. As I mentioned at the beginning of this episode, I want to share with you an exclusive resource. It's my code base remodeler worksheet. It's a framework to think about the 5 key metrics you should be monitoring to tell you what's breaking in your product, where should you be focusing your time. I'm also going to share with you the prioritization framework that I use to understand how to refactor your code base in the right sequence. And then finally, the 5 principles of development so that you can avoid getting back into this exact same spot that you found yourself in into the future. Because if you don't fix that, then you're just going to rewrite or refactor your code base and end up in the same place in 2 or 3 years. So be sure to click the link below to download your copy of my code base remodeler. And if you like this video, be sure to subscribe, leave a comment, and click that like button, smash it. And as per usual, I want to challenge you to live a bigger life and a bigger business, and I'll see you next Monday.